Business Math, Section 9.1, Objective 6, Define Basic Terms Used with Notes. Here we have what's known as a promissory note. It can be written in many forms, but general information is specifically there. It's a legal document, a legally binding document, in which one person or firm agrees to pay a certain amount of money on a specific day in the future to another person or firm. It has the terms of the loan. So some terms that we will define here is the maker or payer. This is the person that's borrowing the money, and this is indicated at the bottom of this promissory note. Madeline Sullivan is the maker or payer, the person borrowing the money. The next term we want to look at is the payee. This is the person who loaned the money or who will receive this payment. And if you read 90 days after date, I promise to pay to the order of, sounds like the payee, and it is the payee. Next, we've already seen this term before. It's term referring to the length of the loan. And on here, some will tell specific dates. This one is telling us the length of the loan is 90 days. Other pertinent information to a promissory note should be the principal, or it's sometimes referred to as the face value. This is the amount borrowed, which is $2,500. And to safeguard this, similar to what we do with checks, they have it not only in numerical form, but also written out. Maturity value is the face value plus interest. We saw that as a formula that we calculated before. And this particular promissory note does not have that information there. It would be the face value or the principal plus interest. We'd have to do some calculation. This is the amount that's borrowed, and it's telling us that they're paying interest at 12% per year, which is simple interest. So we would need to do a calculation to actually determine the maturity value here. The interest would be the principal times the rate as a decimal, and because of the fact that it's saying the term is 90 days, we need to express it as a year, 90, no mention of exact interest, so the assumption is it's ordinary or bankers, so we use 360, calculating that and adding, we end up with a maturity value of $2,575. Another term or piece of information found on a promissory note is the maturity date or due date. This is the date the loan must be paid off with interest, and that is here at the bottom with the due date of June 4th. And we could check that March 6th plus 90 days should put us at this due date of June 4th. A couple other terms in association with a loan is collateral for one. It can be anything that has some value to it, whether it's a vehicle, stocks, some kind of bonds or certificates. And what it actually is an asset that should a borrower default on their loan, the lender could take that in place of the amount of money that the lender is not, or the borrower is not coming forth with and completing their obligation on their promissory note. If you borrowed money and you gave some valuable, say a diamond ring for collateral to hold as a guarantee of your ability and willingness to pay the final value to that individual, the lender, should you default and not pay back the money loaned, including the interest, that person then could keep the diamond in lieu of you paying the mature value of your loan. Another term that goes along with that is when you default, then we have foreclosure. And in 2008, when the housing bubble burst in the United States, we heard a lot about foreclosures happening. And what that means is that the process by which a lender takes back the property when payments are not made. Popular show on some of the networks is repo, where there's groups of people that go and they are repossessing items, whether it's boats, cars, or whatever, from people that have defaulted or have stopped making payments. The last thing that we'll look at is determining the due date of a note. The term of a promissory note is sometimes expressed in months. So if we're calculating the due date, and as an example, if it was made on February 10th and the length of the loan was 3 months, we simply add 3 months onto February. February, March, April, and May would put us on May 10th. If we have April 20th, 7 months from April 20th, we don't have to go to our days of the year, simply move 7 months away from April, which puts us at November 20th. October 18th, 9 months. This is going to put us into the next year because October, November, December, that's only 2 months and we have 7 more months to go. We just start with January and determine what the 7th month is, which hopefully you arrived at July 18th. Should we have a date that's at the end of the month and the term of the loan or length of the loan is also in months, you'll still add your 3 months, but be careful when you add 3 months onto January, January, February, March, April. We might want to say April 31st, but April is one of those months that only has 30 days, so we would be incorrect to put April 31st. Instead, we're going to put April 30th, the last day of the month.